In the response, your grab bag should have, as a bare minimum, short holding statements for the media that will give you breathing space until you can respond to the crisis with more detailed information. This holding statement can simply acknowledge the crisis, saying you are dealing with it and more information will be coming soon. It sends out the message that you are alert and taking the matter seriously. Think of adding important information to these statements, such as a helpline or contact details in case people are worried about the welfare of loved ones. As a rule, have statements and messaging prepared for specific crises that your working group has identified as being relevant to your type of maritime business, including cyber attack, piracy, groundings, sinkings, accident and fatalities, site shutdowns, explosions, strikes, and former employees with an axe to grind leaking sensitive information to the media. Your communications team can then adapt the crisis communications plan to the specific nature of the crisis while monitoring the mainstream and social media and reporting back how the crisis is evolving, documenting what you have said and critically what other businesses and agencies have said to which media and when. It will be important to ensure all reporting is balanced and accurate. We have found opening channels of communication with priority media and editors particularly helpful in this situation, so they become aware you expect all reporting to be accurate and that their news team must come to you for a response. If the media runs an article or broadcast that is unbalanced or inaccurate, request an immediate correction in robust terms with the editor-in-chief. Going to the top shows how serious you are about the issue. And given that your reputation is on the line, you cannot leave anything to chance. A reporter or news editor may not see giving you a correction as a priority unless they hear it from the editor-in-chief. Any feedback presented as a complaint is most unwelcome to newspaper reporters and editors, as they may have to formally explain to their editor-in-chief what they have done to address the complaint. I have found that requesting a correction without having to make a complaint is looked upon much more favourably by journalists. It may be they had to go to press before you responded, as they were under pressure of a deadline. So work constructively with reporters and help them to do their job without dropping them in it. You may not be able to devote time to each individual news outlet, given the overwhelming number of websites and social media accounts now. So prioritising the media is key. Work out which channels reach your stakeholders best. You can look at earned media outlets like news websites, newspapers, radio and TV, and decide which you want to prioritise for briefings and even site visits and face-to-face interviews with the senior leadership team to show them what you are doing to tackle the crisis. Your owned media, like your website and social media channels, will also play a vital role. Here, you can report news in a way that is not at risk of being distorted by the mainstream press. Equally, you can correct misinformation and answer important queries using your social media feeds. Consistency of communication is invaluable. Having the same people giving information at a set time and supplying a source, such as a single website or Twitter feed, where people can get up-to-date information, helps simplify and structure your response. As the crisis develops and peaks, give yourself space to be creative. If you are in a confrontational crisis, you may want to give your team or crew a voice by starting a petition or uploading their authentic quotes on your website and social media, or offering them as interviewees to the media. In addition, the more you engage third parties such as contractors, lobby groups, local politicians, or the public to support your position, say in the example of a strike, the more powerful your response will be. After a period, you should be able to gauge the accepted narrative of the crisis. You can then plan how to move the recovery position and resume normal operations. A big review is necessary at this point to work out the way forward for the organisation, learning lessons for future crises and adapting your day-to-day communications to the accepted narrative of how the company has come out of this one. Your objective is to understand how the event has affected your reputation and people's trust and confidence in the company.